The film is about a dad who relives his journey through its memories.
He realized that the importance of family member is the memory that being shared together.
I think that this film teaches us to appreciate and cherish our lives because we may not know how long we will live.
The dad in the film has to be someone that I can relate to.
So that dad have to bring bread and butter to the family. As a result, he neglected the emotion growth of this child.
My character, the son, I think is closer to the mom because my dad is out working, so I rarely see him.
In this film, I play a mom, and then she's a painter. And this character is very different from the husband.
He's the dad's inspiration's important person.
In this film, the husband and wife share a lot of good memories. These good memories sometimes can be a very painful one.
I remember Ray called me, there's one time, said, Ryan, I want to make a short film. I said, oh, great.
And the director needs someone to paint, and I used to paint. So everything is just a coincidence.
Cherise used to be a painter, and Ryan used to be a mechanic. On top of that, right, the team was encountering with cancer, and Nicholas had some really very visible skin allergies.
Nick is my student, drama student, so we have this mutual understanding. So like teacher and students, we are like father and son, you know.
Ryan is a passionate and very smart actor. When directing, I love to improvise, and Ryan is one actor that can give something new in each and every new take.
And what I admire Ray the most is that he has this special gift to capture the moment of life.
Working with Ray is quite enjoyable because whenever we come to a difficult situation, he can like come up with a lot of ideas to think of.
So Nicholas is a committed actor. He always, you know, he never says no on the set. He's always like, you know, okay, let's do it, you know. I remember there's a scene, I actually needed him to dive deep down into the pool and hold his breath. I think we lost count how many times he actually dived deep down into the pool. But it took us the whole day just to shoot that one shot.
从拍摄开始，然后就很担心会遇到下雨。
Because of the rain, there's no way we can continue to film.
And during the set, you know, we have to put the equipment out and then have to keep the equipment in.
一边等一边担心说，哎，那等一下会不会雨停？所以我们其中有一场就是改成，那不如就直接下雨下去拍。 这也是我觉得Ray他会随机应变的地方。The
film is by far the tightest schedule, minimum crew, and also my first time shooting while directing it.
Talking about losing someone that I love so much, I think that's my second brother. So he's older than me by 2 years old, and he met in car accident. And without any warning, he was gone. So I imply that into this film as well, that I'm losing someone that I love so much. And that's kind of turmoil that's going on in my mind. And it's very memorable, but we did treasure a lot of time being together.
What if finding your late loved ones is just a step away? It's only, you know, the most happiest and the most painful memories you can feel him or her closer to you.
其实我真的很认同这句话，因为当我回忆起我去世的家人的时候，其实都是最极端，然后也是最开心、最美好、最伤心、最痛苦。So
the moment you pick up the memory, you're closer to them, but in reality, they're not with you anymore.
人家说生老病死是旅程，人人必经之路。什么是永恒？我觉得回忆就是永恒，珍惜每一分每一秒，让每一刻的回忆都是永恒，都是美好的。对我来说，是目前最重要的事。
Okay, I hope this film can inspire patience, even their loved ones, you know, that loss is not the end. If you cherish every moment, every second turns into memories, you know, and it shall live forever.